to remind ourselves some of, or what are services, what are some examples? So this is kind of a minor quiz slash review. So I'm going to draw some gluing diagrams for some surfaces, and I'd like you to, in your notebook, try and write down what the surface is, but keep it to yourself for the moment, okay? Taurus. Okay, what was that one? Right, so Andre, what is this one?
It's a sphere.
So how could you see it's a sphere?
Well, because it's glued like a deco.
Yeah, so if you think along that line there, it's like... So this guy is this one. And this guy is that one. So you take your pillowcase and you... It's a sphere. Timon, did you decipher what this guy was?
Timon?
It's tricky. Nikolai? It's a coin model, so it's like a torus. You start with a cylinder, but then you've got a glue. So you form your torus. You form your cylinder. But then you've got to glue this to this in with a twist. So it makes a clean bottle, so it's a clean bottle. Nikolai number two?
It's a...
Timon?
A torus?
It's a torus. Oh. So you roll it up, and this time you can look these. It's a torus. What about number five? Who? Andre?
It's a projective plane.
It's a projective plane. Okay. This way. Right. So if we consider it like a sphere like we did before, on this side, and we've got this side. But now this side is glued to this side going that way. You see that? I labeled it funny, but A, B reverse, A, B reverse. So see that's the same as you take your disc and you fold it up, but you fold up the edges with an opposite identification. So this point here is identified with this, and so it's a bridge. Okay, now what about this one? We want to figure out
it's a triangle.
Nikolai thinks this is a Klein bottle.
Andre
thinks it's a Klein bottle. Does anyone else have any ideas? So Klein bottle or a torus? Nikola, would you like to give us a proof that this is the same as that, or would you like me to do it?
Once again, I'm Andrew. I'm not even there.
Okay.
I can give a proof, but I can. May I?
Yes, please. So the claim is that this diagram, by cutting and pasting, is the same as this diagram. So let me erase the things for you. What is yours?
Okay. Well, explain this on this board.
So we'd like to... Let's start with here, Nikola. And by cutting... Andrew. And let's get to here.
Yes. Well, we have this, and we cut it here, so it's C.
Get two pieces.
Put this triangle like this. You see that?
Oh, and Nikolai, Andre, could you give us an intermediate step? Could you draw the two triangles you get first?
Okay.
So first we cut.
So. C. A, B.
So we cut, but remember that we have to glue along where we cut, because we don't want to change the surface.
Comes the second one. So you see that this triangle is this one, and this one is this one.
So this one, you rotate it.
I flipped it. I just flipped.
Yeah.
and I've rotated this one. And now I can glue them, these two edges, together. And then I'll get this. Now you can clearly see that that's a climbing model.
Very good. Well then, I guess that one was a climbing model. That's a bit tricky, but... So we noticed this earlier that we have different gluing diagrams for the same surface. Okay, good. I gave you some homework last week. How many distinct vertices do these surfaces have? How many? So let me draw these again. So not last week, 2 weeks ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Sure, again. Start with these. Would anyone like to come up and count the number of vertices on this surface? Nikolai, do you want to have a stab?
Yeah.
So firstly, what is the surface?
It's a sphere.
It's a sphere.
Point like this.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like this. Because this is this.
No. You're wrong because medias on there. This point, it's in the top of A, so it's on the A where on it's the side of the A to which the arrow is pointing. So it's the same as this one. But this and these points are not the same. B and C. So there are three distinct vertices. Because these two are glued together, and these two remain unique.
So how many? So what is the answer?
Three.
Anyone else like to have a try?
One.
Demo.
One,
please. What is the surface?
This.
What is the surface?
What is the store?
U.S.
It's okay. It's not an English.
Yes,
and this one
English. Сейчас
две буквы.
Yes.
U.S.
Уже есть.
Ну, сейчас есть А. Извините.
It's a math class. It doesn't
matter. This goes to this, and this goes.
Okay, so as is A the same as B?
No,
yes.
Нет, секунду. Вы не поняли. Когда стрелочка стоит, это значит, что этот отрезок склеивается с другим.
Он понял, он уже сказал, что A и B это одно и то же.
Да. Yes.
So it's just one vertex.
Yes,
one. Very good, thank you. Would anyone want to have a go at this one, Nikolai?
Mm-hmm. It's a climbing bottle.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, for example, this is A. This is A.
So why is it wrong?
It's on the end of B.
Oh,
yes.
Start of A. Mm-hmm.
And it's two on the end of B. And this is on the other end of B. And so it's A2 because other ends of B.
Yep.
So one vertical.
Good, excellent. So one more surface. Dharmi, can I pick on you? Dharmi, would you like to have a try? Maybe start here and see where else you can call.
This is like.
Новую букву кому-нибудь поставьте.
It says, and then see, so is there any way to say that A is the same as B, or A and B different?
No,
they're different. So two vertices. Very good. And Dara, do you remember the name of that object? Begins with P, in English.
Проективная плоскость.
And so just remember that these depend on the number of vertices depends on the type of diagram. It's not it's not unique given a particular surface. For example, the sphere, we know that we could draw a diagram for a sphere. With two vertices. And so this number here is it depends on the diagram, it's not unique to a sphere. But what we'll probably talk about next time is there is a number called the Euler characteristic, which you obtain from a diagram by counting up the vertices and the edges, and you obtain a number which is uniquely determined by the surface, but I don't think we'll talk about that today. Okay, so another thing I want to return to is gluing surfaces together. Let me just make that note. Number of vertices of a gluing diagram for a surface may change depending on the surface. I'll try to write down things that I say so that it's... So here's an exercise, then. For two diagrams, gluing diagram, for the projective plane with different number of vertices, with the number of... So here I gave an example of two diagrams for a sphere. With this one had three vertices and this one has two vertices. I'd like you to do the same for the projective plane. Is the problem clear?
Yes.
No, Andre's got one. Anyone else come up with two examples? Projective plane.
Well, first one is obvious. You gave it to us. Okay. Make the second one by separating the B into two different edges. As you can see, this can be transformed into this. But now, this thing has only two. This one has only two vertices, while this one has three of them. So it's A, A, B, B, and here it's A, A, B, B, C.
Following Andre's example, I have a question. Can you draw a diagram for the projective plane? Is there a maximum number of vertices?
No. Sorry.
Could you draw a diagram with more than 100 vertices?
Yes.
So there's no limit.
Yes.
What is the minimal number of vertices? Could you have a diagram with one vertex, two vertices, three vertices?
Yes, we can have.
Nicola, can you draw us one with
it's
two
already
vertices?
Drawn there.
Two?
Yes, it's already drawn.
Oh, I see. Thank you. So you can't have one?
No.
So one would be... Wouldn't make sense.
One, like this, and we can do it as more.
It wouldn't be a projective plane. Mm-hmm. Okay, so two vertices. So there is.
Maybe we can. I'm not really sure, but. Okay.
So I think we're right. Yeah.
Yes. So we can unite these two. We can make one out of them.
Mm-hmm.
So then we'll have it like this. But it will still have two, so no, we can't.
Where's the end of A? Could you point to the end of little a?
Well, this is the beginning,
yes,
and that's the end.
But look at the other side.
Это одна и та же точка.
Look at
the other. Вы все сделали, вы придумали.
Yes.
I made the same mistake when I said that we couldn't get two. So in fact, you can get one. Looks like two.
Коля, ты понял, что сейчас нарисовали с одной точкой?
Да.
Это склеивание АА.
But you obviously cannot get zero.
Just disk. So if you hit,
I mean for the projective game.
Well, in I'm thinking of any diagram to have vertices, it would have to be a circle. Okay, good. Let's return to gluing diagrams.
Склеивание диаграмм склеивания.
So today I'd like to talk about the Kinect Summit at some stage, but before that, I'd like to talk about just gluing surfaces in a more simpler way. So if gluing surfaces are common
boundary.
The boundary граница.
Pictorially, so for example, pictorially without gluing diagrams, if I have a cylinder. Cylinder. How many edges does a cylinder have?
Two.
These two. Okay. So, but it's, suppose I take this cylinder with this yellow edge, and I take a disc, and I glue.
Sorry.
I
have a question.
Yes.
Maybe it's different to the team, but how to count edges?
Edges of a diagram?
On the diagram, yeah. It's
yes.
Clearly.
Сколько у тебя маленьких буквок, столько и границ.
Нет, я не прав.
Свободных сторон без буквок, столько и границ.
Сколько один раз встречающихся маленьких букв?
Ну, один раз встречающихся не бывает, они всегда как минимум...
Нет.
Они всегда как минимум два раза, потому что они обозначают то, что склеивается между собой.
Когда склеивается, это не граница.
I mean, that the number...
Когда они склеиваются, это ребро или не... Или это не ребро или нет?
Ну, когда... Еще раз...
Это не граница. Когда склеится, это не
граница. Я сейчас объясню, и я сейчас скажу прав или нет. I'm going to explain it in English, and you'll say if I'm right or not. So, the number of edges of a surface is the number of spare edges with no letters on the diagram. On the cylinder, it has two edges without any letters, and they are not connected on the diagram. So the cylinder's diagram. Okay.
Oh, boundary. Okay.
Yes, and these two edges are different, and they have no letters drawn. While a member stripe has only one edge, because these two are the same. They have no letters, but they're the same. So.
Так не бывает, чтобы не было букв, но они были бы одним и тем же.
В смысле? Еще раз, нет members.
Nicolas, stay there, Andre, and this might help. Andre, on the first diagram, could you draw all the distinct vertices?
Yes. Well, it's this and this.
Could you label them?
A and B.
In the other places? In the first diagram?
Oh, in the first, it's also B and also
B. Okay, so maybe this will help you see. Because this edge is connecting to B's. This edge is connecting to A's.
Yeah, but A and B, yeah, I understand. They're the same, yeah. No,
it's A,
B, and there is two AB, yeah.
So now you see when you come to here, you're here, and then...
Yes, I understand.
No, very good question, very good question. And so there is a called... So The proper name for these, so this is called a boundary component. It's one boundary component, and this one here, a different boundary. And if we have surfaces which have boundary components in common, for example, the boundary of this cylinder is the same as a circle, and the boundary of this disc is a cylinder, disc, we can glue the disc to the cylinder along this common circle. So we get that cylinder. Okay, now we're going to plonk that disc on the top. So, Nikolai, can you tell us what would this be? If I take a cylinder and I cap off the top, what is the surface we get?
Cup.
It's it. Okay, so it looks like it's the same as that.
Yeah.
And now push that thing down.
Mm-hmm.
And you get a
circle.
A filled in surface, a disc.
Yeah.
So imagine your cup is really made of plastic and
yeah.
It's got really hot and you're able to mold it and so you get a disc. So gluing a cylinder along a filled disc gives you a disc. And so that's how we can draw. Often we can draw the gluing, but sometimes we can't draw the gluing in free space. For example, I can draw on the Möbius strip today. So the Möbius strip, Andre drew a moment ago. So as we just observed, the Möbius strip is how many boundary components? Here and then we're here, just the one. So that's a circle. So we made that on our first day. It's just one boundary point, a circle. So therefore, it also is a circle like the cylinder in the boundary. So we should be able to glue a disc onto it, for example. But before we do that, let's take two Möbius strips as boundary. Each two Möbius, they each have a circle boundary. Okay. So we should be able to glue two Möbius strips together along that common circle. They each have a circle there, so let's glue them together. So, okay. So this, maybe I'll show you how to do this. So it's not quite clear. So no, it's. I mean, no. So if I draw two of those diagrams. So we try to do this gluing. The goal is to glue the two common boundaries together to get a surface. But it isn't quite clear from the diagram how to do that because we have the edge on different sides. So what we can do is give a different diagram for the Möbius strip. So what we could do instead is what I like to do is give a different diagram for the Möbius strip that's going to make it a little bit easier to glue. Okay? So we start with the Möbius strip. What we'll do is we'll cut along the diagonal. The objective being that we're going to cut it and glue that these two sides together. So we cut and re-glue. Okay, so now there's an exercise for you guys in your notebook. I'd like you to redraw this diagram so that the A is glued together. So, glue, A is. Okay, see if you can. Okay, good. Excellent. Nikolai, would you like to come up and draw it for us? Yeah, right.
Okay, it would be like a triangle, maybe. Okay, C. And that's A.
Could you give us how did you go from, could you tell us where is this and where is this? How did you?
It's the yellow edges are this is content. Make this a bit edge and I.
Коль, напишите там буквы на этих желтых, там, не знаю, там, X, Y, и напишите, ну, куда-нибудь.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's X, and it's Y.
X,
I turned this like this, and it's X. Yeah, that's X, and that's Y.
Why?
Why?
Why? Yes.
Okay. Wonderful. Very good. So we've got another. Diamond for the Möbius strip. So it's just. And now we've got this boundary component, just on one line. Just on one line. So now. Okay. So now if we take two of these. It's a little bit more clearer how to glue these two together because we have a line. So now, taking two, let's take. Okay, take two of them and glue along the yellow. Draw, could you, what do we get? Would you want to come and draw for us?
Этот отрезок уже не нужен, он склеен.
That's okay, that's okay. You can draw the yellow just so it's clear that you...
В другую сторону. Вот правая верхняя B, в другую сторону стрелочка. Потому что... Они...
So notice it goes B, B. So B, B. See, have a look. Are you sure about that?
Why? The B, no. The A is, you can do like this, but the B is, you can't make one edge of two.
Yes, you cannot do it.
Yes.
So, Nikolai, are you thinking, of this being, of, maybe,
it would be like a triangle. No.
Там не получится так.
Сначала B, A, а там другой порядок. A, B. B, A не равно A, B. Поэтому ты не прав. Проследи вот рукой. В одном случае нужно будет тебе идти B, A, в другом случае нужно будет идти A, B. А это разные вещи.
This edge and this edge. So this way and this way.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So if we look at this, so here we go B A, here we go A B. So this would be. So this is BA, this is AB, so it's not,
yeah.
It's not the reverse, not quite the reverse, but it's, if it were BA,
yeah.
Then would be BA, BA, and then would have this.
Yes.
Okay, so we've got this instead. But it's very, it can be very good. So it's not, so this is, so I think you said it is a Klein bottle, can you remember why that was a climb bottle? So let me draw that. Right. If you can look. Okay, so now we've seen Timon and Andre both show this is a climb bottle. So from now on, let's try and remember that AABB is a climb bottle. Okay, so we've got two different versions of a climb bottle. Very good. So let's just summarize. So that's a Klein bottle. So taking two Möbius strips and gluing along their common boundary, we got a Klein bottle. Okay, so let me just write. And notice that, remember that we can't draw the Klein bottle in three dimensions. So this is an example where we need gluing diagrams, or at least gluing diagrams give us a way to see that two of these two surfaces glued together to the Klein bottle, whereas we can't draw it or shape it with paper ourselves. Okay. That's why gluing diagrams are really, really useful. Okay, so let's...
Yeah.
А всегда можно нарисовать вот эту диаграмму склеивания без самопересечения?
Что такое без самопересечения? Он тебе только что объяснил, что в трехмерном пространстве...
Нет, а в двухмерном, когда у меня план есть.
В двумерном она всегда является многоугольником.
Если у тебя есть самопересечение на этой диаграмме, ты можешь просто что-то на ней подвигать.
Да, ты можешь отрезать и приставить.
Да, не обязательно даже отрезать и приставить, ты можешь просто без отрезания что-то подвигать.
Да. А сейчас он говорил не про это. Сейчас он говорил, что в пространстве, в нашем трехмерном, эту операцию сделать иногда невозможно.
Да. Okay, so let's drink up as a one more. Movie strip. Let's take the movie strip, which has a circle boundary. What other shape has a circle boundary? Circular boundary. A boundary with that just consists of one circle.
A disc.
Just a plain disc. So it was a trick question. And so let's take a movie strip then and glue it to a disc. Take it. Glue a disc. Okay, so here's our movie strip, and let's draw a disc with one edge. So one way would be, can you see that? Why that's a disc? It's like a cone, and exactly, it's a picture of a cone. When I fold up the beads. So now let's glue the movie strip to the disc along that yellow boundary. Okay, we can sort of see what we get. So pop that on top. Do you like? I think you need to draw it. So I've got the bottom.
На него надо нажать сверху.
The bottom piece, A. And I put this on top. Can you see what this surface is?
It's the.
Мы 2 недели назад это обсуждали.
Is it?
It's a projective plane.
So is that the diagram we originally gave for a projective plane?
No.
Okay, do you want to show us why it's a projective plane?
Yes. Well, you see, we can just get rid of these two edges because they actually form a cylinder which we can slowly scale down up to zero because it's a filled edge. So actually this is the same as this.
I mean, so maybe instead of A, you could call them C?
No, that's actually the A's.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so could you give us an intermediate step?
So I'll try. I mean, we can... That's hard. Well, that's hard to draw. That we can connect. And then they actually form a filled disk, which we can slowly scale down while it doesn't disappear.
So it's not so hard to draw. We can just push this guy down. So stick with this. Yeah. Take it. Good. And you can push it down a little bit further if you like.
Okay. Mm. Oh, yeah. Now I see.
Mm-hmm.
So, mm-hmm. Now we can glue these two dots together. And then it forms...
Notice that we mentioned this last time, is if you have two consecutive edges, they're labeled the same letter, but in the reverse order, so B, then B in the other direction, they, if you push down the vertex, like Andre did, and you see they glue together and you eliminate that edge altogether. Okay, so that disappears. These two diagrams for this. So that's going to be an important observation. Let's summarize. So taking a movie strip and a disc gives us a projective plane. In particular, we've seen that the Klein bottle contains a Möbius strip. How many Möbius strips does it contain?
Two.
It contains two. So both the Klein bottle and the complete the plan and move this at least one. So we take the Möbius projective plane, we know that we can decompose it into one piece which is a Möbius strip, another piece which is a disc. And whenever a surface contains a Möbius strip, we said that surface is not orientable. Okay, so climb bottle and a projective plane both contain Möbius strip. Such surfaces are not. This is something we talked about informally on the first day. Conversely, if a surface doesn't contain a Möbius strip, then it's orientable. Okay, now, so we looked at how to glue surfaces if we have a boundary component to glue along. Okay, so here we need a Möbius strip which has a boundary and a disc has a boundary. What about if we start with two surfaces that don't have a boundary? Ultimately, so we'd like to describe a picture like this. We start with a torus, and maybe we start to have another torus. Now, to tori, does a torus have any boundary components?
No.
And so we can't just glue along their boundary because they don't have boundaries. But what we can do is glue them by first removing a disc. Okay, so what we'll do is, this is called the connect sum. What we'll do is we start with two tori, but we want to construct a new surface that we haven't seen before. And so what we'll do, and this is just informally, we'll explore it in more detail in a moment. What we'll do is we'll remove a disc from the torus, on this torus, and we'll remove a disc from this torus. Okay, so we'll take minus the disc, and now, if I remove this little disc from this torus, then the resulting surface has the circle on the boundary. And same with this torus where I've moved a disc. Okay. And so therefore I can glue these two surfaces with boundary along this common circle. So we glue, and so what we get is a surface like this. So this will be called, well, I'll formalize in a second, but this will be called the connect sum. Connect or connected sum. Okay, so that's how we can draw it. But before that, I want to think about this operation of removing a disc.
Remove balloon.
And so in the picture, it's easy to draw how to remove a disc. But what about in a gluing diagram? Because this is what we're going to need to form connect sums. So I could separate the exercises. So what I'd like you to do is to start with a torus, a diagram for a torus. And what I'd like you to do is cut out the following disc. So remember that these corners are all the same. What I'd like you to do is cut out these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so what I like to do is, in either physically or on paper, cut out the four quarters, and re-glue. Okay, so everyone, I'd like you to. So let me start you off. So. If I cut out this number one, so remember that these vertices are the same, A. We'll do this for various surfaces, but what I'd like you to do is cut out this number one, cut out the number two, number four, three, and keep track of the identification. So here, if I label this B1, this B1 is being glued to this B1, this edge here, let's call it A2 here, that's being glued to this A2. I'll continue. So I'm just cutting out these corners, these quarter discs, and I'm just noting how they glue together in the diagram. So for example, this little bit edge here on my diagram for the torus, that's glued to this point. Do you see? And so I just drew that they're identified here. Okay. And so if I continue, let's label this one B2. B2 is labeled with this B2. And finally this A1 is glued with this A1. Okay, so I've got four pieces, and this has been glued to this, this has been glued to this. So I'd like you to arrange them into getting those four quarters into a single disc, you see? And I'd like you to do that with the torus, but also I'd like you to do it with the climb model, the one, and then two. And so I'd like you to write down what these numbers look like, okay? And do the same for the climb model. And do the same for the projective plane. This would be quite interesting. Are the instructions clear?
Mm-hmm. The same as for the torus, yes?
So this is the torus. And then I'd like you to do the same for the climb bottle.
Yeah.
And in the projective plane.
Yeah.
Oh, so you're already doing the climb model. Did you? Oh, that's the projective plane. Did you do the torus? Oh, so did you decide what this was?
It's a circle.
What I'd like you to draw is what goes here, what number?
Oh, here.
So you take these four pieces.
This one.
And you glue them up.
A, B2, B2, A1, B1, and B2, and B1.
So I'd just like you to put these.
Oh, okay.
So maybe I'll do this one, and you can do the other ones. Okay, so this. Let's put this one here. Okay, now B1 matches if this is B1, so I'll put that one there. And then I've got this A1. A1 will match with this one, so I'll put the 3 there. There. And then on the bottom of B3 I've got this B2. And that B2 and this A2 will fit nicely here, so I'll put that there. So what I'd like you to do is do the same for the climb bottle and write down what the numbers look like. And do the same for the projector plane. Okay, so here, notice I took the torus and I cut out these quarter discs and I put them together and I got this disc. But what do you get when you do the same for these two? If you do have scissors, they could actually help. So which quarter is that?
Equally.
Yeah. So which one of these is that?
One here, one there, A1, A2, and B1.
Yeah. So which quarter? You've got four quarters, four pieces.
Yeah.
Which is this piece here? So you've got four pieces here, but this is B2 and this is B1.
Yeah.
So you should. So let's see here. So for example, so take this one, B1, A2.
Yeah.
Okay, so we want to glue that to A2.
It's like this.
Yeah, so let's draw arrows. So sure, A2.
And A2.
And B1. Okay, so now take this guy, and you want to take this guy.
Okay.
And then you want to go to that one. So you've got this piece and you've got this piece. See, we've got A2s. A2s. So this is... So which piece is this? It's this one, yep, so you flip that over. Okay, so now you've got to glue this guy to that guy. Excellent. Okay, so now what is that surface?
This is
Okay, so maybe we could keep track. So that was one, and this was two. Okay, and this one, and then you went from here to here. So what happened to this one? You flipped, so what happened to the number one there?
Over here.
Yeah. So what I'd like you to do is, can you draw that one in here? Because remember, the top of the one is at B1. Oh, excuse me, sorry, that is easy, so you're absolutely right. This one here, is this, yeah, okay, so going from here to here, though, where is the bottom of the two? The bottom of the two is along the B1. So you sure that's a two?
That
is one. No. So you had two pieces.
Yes.
Okay, and then you got another two pieces. This piece,
please.
Right. So, okay. It's upside down. Okay.
And this.
How are we getting on, everyone? Did we decide?
Yeah. Well, I just want to show.
Yep. And once you, and Timon, did you decide what you get when you do it with the climb bottle?
I'm not going.
When you cut out the four corners, did you glue them together?
Yeah.
And label the. Label the quarters?
Yeah, I label the quarters and it's different a bit.
Okay, and Andre, did you do the, Andre,
yes.
Do you want to have got this one afterwards?
Yes, but on the projector plane, I actually have two different
like in this board.
Variant.
This is good, you can show it. Excellent, so Nikolai is showing us what happens when you cut four quarter pieces.
I'm not good at drawing, but...
Better. You're better than I am. That's right. Good.
Okay. Let's name that as B. B1. B2. And that.
So you're doing the climb bottle?
No, projective plane.
Oh, okay.
Okay, that will be B1, that will be B2.
Are you sure? Where does... Look at your diagram, Nicola.
It will be B1 and that will be B2.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, understood. That A.
Oh, so this is... Are you doing it? This is the climb bottle. I think you want to do the climb bottle, so this is the climb bottle.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to do the pretty good one.
Okay. Oh, we have one and two. Yeah.
Oh,
we can turn that.
Nikolai, could you give us just an intermediate step? Could you just draw the four pieces?
The four pieces?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I was wrong when I drew...
Неважно. То, что вы ошибались, никого не интересует сейчас.
It's an intermediate step.
Он просит отдельно нарисовать четыре кусочка.
Отдельно. Я думаю, все сразу.
Нет, и потом нарисовать сразу. Потом склеить.
B1. A2. That is the first piece, and that's the second, B2, A2, and the second, the third, oh, the fourth, it will be the fourth, A1, that's B2, and the third is B1, and A1.
Mm-hmm.
So we will go the first and the second. It will be like a half. One, two, A two, and that will be B one, and that will be B two. Oh no. Yeah, that will be B two. Yeah, that's right. And the three and four, it will be A one. That's the fourth, and then the third. That will be B1. So we can rotate. We will get
So what is the rotation? Maybe you can show us with your hands how do you rotate?
We took here to here. On
Нет, не вращение. Флип.
Флип, yes. Thank you.
Rotation about the vertical axis.
Yeah. So we will get like this.
Is that what happens when you rotate?
Whoa.
Does the fall here? There. Where does this line go?
To this line. Where does this line go? This line goes to this.
Point to
and,
it.
How would you say?
Just draw under your rotation or flip. What does that go here?
It's here.
So how does the fall look like?
So
that long four. So this, notice that this side of your four, right, that's so I'm asking, how does a four, how does this four look?
My English is not
just,
very good.
Just here is a four, chitiri.
Yeah.
Chitiri, toja. Так, how does it look?
It will be different and it will
нарисуй,
короче,
флип.
Окей.
Куда
ты должен повернуть? B2 и A. Вот это я понял.
Напиши, как она будет.
Напиши цифру 4.
Просто написать цифру 4 в перевернутом виде.
Ну нос, в одну сторону, нос в другую.
И 3 тоже, кстати.
And very good. So it doesn't look like this. Very interesting, isn't it? And Andre, would you like to share us how the projector plane, whatever it is, the projector plane? I'll let me erase for you. And again, like Nikolai, if you show us the steps.
Okay. Well, if we start with such glowing diagram, like if we start with a glowing diagram like this, then we'll get two discs. I'll show you how they look in a minute. So, once again, one, two, three, four. And now we can label the sides. That's A1. That's A2.
That's also A1. That's also A2. This is B1. B2. That's B1. B2. And now, if we look, for example, at pieces 1 and 3, we can glue them together by the A2 side. But then...
One second, Andre. So how did you...
I flipped the third piece and put it here. So, like this, and this. And then we get these two edges, which are actually the same.
Are you sure that the three doesn't change on your foot?
Well...
Yeah,
I mean... Well, I mean, now A2.
What if
I flipped it so that A2.
What if I gave you 3 and like that?
Yes, then it looked like this.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, and then we glue these two edges together and get. This. The same thing with 4 and 2. We'll get something like...
Maybe you could give us an intermediate step so it's clear to everyone.
That's 2 and 4. That's 3 and 1. And that's 2 and 4. But I'll erase.
So just in summary, you cut out one disc from the predictive plane, and how many discs did he get?
Two.
So you got 2 discs.
But if we get this line diagram and do everything on it.
So take a different glowing diagram for the predictive plane.
And cut out 1 and 2. Then this is glued to this, so let's see A1 and A1, A2 and A2. So now when we glue them, we get 1. Which is basically the same. Yes.
So different gluing diagram and cut out a disc.
And now we get only one
of these. So we can, Andre showed that you can decompose the projective plane into 3 discs?
Not actually 3 discs.
2 discs and something else.
2 discs and a Möbius strip.
2 discs and a Möbius strip?
Yes.
In this last one?
And in the first one, I think it was 2 discs and a projective plane with 4 holes.
It's a bit complicated, but assuming the number of discs that you get out differs just by cutting out the vertices. Before I want to mention another thing that will help us in writing down these in drawing these gluing diagrams. Notice that in our gluing diagrams, for example, if we take the torus, being topologists, we don't care about the shape of this edge, whether it's squiggly or whatnot, so long as we know that it's identified with this edge. And so and the direction of the siege is going. So all we care about is, when we're doing these diagrams, are the labels on the edges as we go around. For example, to this diagram, if I write down the word, A, I start here and I go A, B, and then as I continue along, I'm not going on A, but I'm going in the opposite direction.
Like,
so maybe A inverse, or A bar, however you like, and then B bar. This word, it's called it's a word in mathematics, encaptures all the information in my gluing diagram. From this word, I can draw a gluing diagram. I know I've got four edges. I start at the point, and I just go A, B, A reverse, and B reverse. Okay, so from a word, I can draw a diagram. Is that? So this is a gluing diagram. And this is a word. But notice that in forming my word, in this case I started here and I went A inverse, B inverse. But I could have started here.
Yeah.
And so I could have also done B, A inverse, B inverse, A. So we can cycle the word. So this is called cycling. Cycle. And of course, also we could relabel the diagram.
Relabel это переобозначить. Label метка.
The word. If we now cycling and relabeling. So by relabeling, I mean, for example, in our diagram.
One letter C. In
one element.
Cycling. After the Y.
Cycling. We could also relabel. So instead of my torus being A, B, A inverse, B inverse, of course I could do D. Relabel everything, and we could also change the direction we go around the torus. So in this example, instead of going this way, we could go the other way. D, C, D inverse, C. But the point is that if we have a word, we can draw a gluing diagram. If we have a gluing diagram, we can draw a word, and they're going to give the same surface. This will be helpful for one thing, this will help when you're manipulating diagrams, because you can just keep track of the labeling. We'll see that in a second. Okay, so that's how we can encode gluing diagrams. Now let's look at the connect sum.